I'm gonna keep this short and clean. Nikon D850. The exact same results were obtained with a Nikon D810. Just to eliminate the factor camera here, it's not the camera, but you're gonna see it's not due to the camera. This is the 50mm 1.8G. This is the 85 1.4G. This is the Zeiss 135 APOS Honor, and this is the Nikon 70-200 f4 VR, which in my opinion it's the sharpest lens Nikon, I mean the sharpest zoom lens at least Nikon ever produced. In all my tests it's been the sharpest, and it's this is handheld. It's got an amazing VR. My daughter got tack sharp pictures while I was driving 70 miles an hour with this lens. It's an incredible lens indeed. And I don't know, some people are not saying good things about it. Some other people just pray by it because it's half the weight of the 2.8. It's got better VR. It's got higher resolution. I don't know what they think are finding wrong with this lens, but I will concentrate on the 85 1.4G. And you can see here the double color text, which you do not see with the Zeiss, you do not see with the other two Nikons. Double color text, and this result was confirmed by taking the same picture on two different days, one with harsh light and the other with relatively soft light. Under soft light the effect was a little lower, a little subdued. This is false color, or color moire, as some say it, and you're not gonna ever notice it with this lens unless you take a picture like this. So street photography, you will most likely notice it if you have shops with small signs and the light falls in such an angle, you will probably notice it. You're not gonna ever notice it in portraits. It's a wonderful portrait lens, one of the best in the world. You're not gonna notice it in general landscape, like if you take pictures in October, fall pictures in October, you're not gonna notice it. As a matter of fact, you will be very pleased with this lens in autumn landscapes. But you see, and you cannot see it like that. In a normal setting, you cannot see it at all. But here's how it happens. So it's not just the camera that produces moire, and the anti-aliasing filter is not gonna save you. It's also the lens that contributes to this effect. Sometimes you have moire, you change lenses, and it's all gone. Exception is video. Video is a little more susceptible to it. That's it. Thanks a lot. Bye.